So, where date? What is date? Date is a new instance of date object. So, date is a built-in object in JavaScript, and date is a variable. Date is a new instance of date object, which is a constructor function. Now, to check the value of date, let's have a p tag document dot query selector p dot inner HTML equal to date. So see, this is the value. So we got a string. So this is not a string, actually this is an object. This is not a string, it's an object. Check. Type of date is an object. So this is not a string, this is an object. So in this object we have the day, we have the month, year, and all the information related to date and time. Now this is to get complete, we use date object. We can also pass an argument in date. So let's say my argument is a string which is 2000. So see, what's the output now? So it's Saturday, Jan 01 2000. So this means this is 2000 year. So if there's no argument inside date, this is the date and time of my device or my machine. So this is the date and device time of my system. And if we pass some argument, let's say year 2000. So this is date and time of 2000, 1st Jan 2000. Now to change the month, 02. So this is 1st Feb 2000. And also to change the date, let's say 08. So this is 8th of Feb 2000. And that was Tuesday, and the time GMT, Greenwich Mean Time, plus 5:30 means I'm using Indian time zone. So for India, the time zone offset is plus 5:30, and it's IST, which is Indian Standard Time. So this means a particular date, and this means computer's date. So we can also pass an argument inside new date. But to get system date, there should be blank, no argument. Okay. So there shouldn't be any, no need to pass any argument, leave it blank. So this is Sunday, today's date, month, date, year, and time. Now this is date object. To get only year, use, or to get only date, dot get date. So date dot get date means only day date. So date is 12. So earlier we were using getting complete date, now we are getting only date. So to get date, use get date. So get date means only date. To get month, use get month function. So get month method means 3. So now 3 is the indexing, so this will work from 0 to 12. So 0 means Jan and 11 means December. So for Apple, this is 3. So this is indexing of month. So if you have an array, so you can pass this. So get month is an array of month. To get year, we have two functions. First is get year, which is 120. So this is 120. So why it's 120? This is my year as per 1900 era. So computers were started in 1900 century. So this year is calculating year from 1900 era. So to get complete year, use get full year. Now this will return the absolute year, which is 2020. So earlier it was 120, so that was with reference to 1900. Before that, for full year, year you have to add 1900 to get full year. So that's why we always use get full year, not full year. So this is, now to get time, we use get hours. So first is get hours. So this is hours. Again, this is in 24 hour format. So this will be between 0 to 23. So in my system, the current time is right now 11:16. So this is 11 now. To get minutes, use get minutes. Now we are getting minutes. To get seconds, we use gets seconds. Now this is second, but seconds are not changing. So see the right right now the second is 29, it's 30 now, but it's still 22. So we have to repeat or call this function after every 1 second. So for that, function show date. Now call this function using set interval. So with set interval, first argument should be show date and second is the time, so we need 1000. But the thing is show date, 1 second. So now first time this function will be called after 1 second. So to call it immediately, use now instant. So this will call the function instantly and this will call the function after 1 second. So this is to change seconds after 1 second. To get in milliseconds, use get milliseconds. So now these are milliseconds, but for milliseconds this iteration should be fast, so use without any argument. Now these are in milliseconds. So for milliseconds you can, so if you want to change milliseconds in after 100 ms, so pass 100, so this means 100 milliseconds, this means after change after 10 milliseconds, and this means as soon as possible. So for only milliseconds we have to change frequency, but for seconds the second argument should be 100 is enough. So this function will be called after 1 second. So we got date object, new date, full year, month, get date, get minutes, get seconds, get milliseconds. Okay, and now we have another function that is get time. So what is get time? So get time is a number, but what's this number? This is approach time from 1st Jan 1970. So this is a timer. So again, this is in milliseconds, so just remove 1000. So this is in milliseconds, so this is called means this is a millisecond started from 1st Jan 1970. So means ms milliseconds from 1st Jan 1970 0000, and time zone is not IST, GMT. So GMT means London. So this is milli seconds from 1st Jan 1970 0 hour 0 minute 0 second and GMT. Okay, we use them only in cookies or some other applications. So this is get time. To date string, to convert this into date, we use date string. To date string. So now this is in date string. To get in local date string, use to local date string. So this is my DD, MM, and YYYY format. Same to get time, we use to time string or to local time string. This is to time string, and this is to local time string. Then to local string, this will return both date and time. So we got first date and then time. So if you want both, use to local string. To get this form in ISO format, tools to get GMT or ISO, or use to UTC string. So this is the time of GMT. So it's Sunday, 12 April, and there the time is 5:51. So in India, the time is 11:21, and there the time is 5:51. We can also check the clock. So see, at London, this is the time. It's 6. And but as per this device, it's cause just because of daytime saving. So there's been some time difference because of daytime saving. So see, as per this my system's clock, the time at London is 6:50, but at as per this clock, it's 5:52. So but my device is showing 6:52 just because of daytime saving. But this is the actual one. Same, we can convert this to JSON, which is again in UTC, or to ISO string, to local date string, to time string UTC, to time zone offset. So what is time zone offset? It's -330. So this means the difference between my time zone and GMT. So GMT is London is +5:30 ahead. So we are 5.5 hours ahead of London time zone. So difference will be -330. So which means 5 hours. So it's 5 hours and 30 minutes. So in 1 hour we have 300. So in 1 hour we got 300 minutes plus extra 30. So this is 330. So we have to reduce 330 minutes from our time to reach GMT time. So this is your date and time function in JavaScript. So let's print a digital clock or analog digital clock. We just use two local string. So this is a digital clock with this is the date and this is the time. So this is in 24-hour format. So just make sure if you want to manipulate this AM PM, you have to use if conditions. Okay. So this is date and time object in JavaScript.